Va a tratar exactly the way, girls, the way you expose yourself, the way you present yourself. So the first value that you have to give is give it to yourself, not to the guy, not to the person, first you. Remember lo que dije, si hay una cosa importante, es love yourself, and then you can love God. You cannot love God unless you love yourself. Dice this guy, well, there's this message que encontré, and they're not Christian, and it's a guy, young guy, single, que lo están llevando a predicar, not preach at schools, to teach about purity, pureza. Porque sí, nos han dicho sobre pureza, and also for us to be scared because all the sexual disease and all the problems and all the things, but actually purity is to keep your life, first of all, holy in front of God. Second, it prepares your life for your future, which is your marriage. Again, how many of you want to get married one day and have a family? Raise your hand. Well, guess what? Yesterday we had also preaching and he gave a good message, but guess what? A good family, it starts at your age, right now, making the right decisions, making the good choices and the right choices, right now. So there's girls can hoy en día, they okay give sex so they can get love, and there's guys that they should show love so they can get sex. So it's like a trading market right now, where people or young people sometimes they don't respect themselves. So terminan como Shiniqua, you know, ella dijo que la quiero, o there was this guy que preguntaba, well, how far is too far with the girl? I mean, first of all, are you interested with the girl? You like the girl? Well, yeah, well, we Christians, and but you know, we've been boyfriend and girlfriend for this and this such a time, how far is too far? Let me tell you something. How do you know? First of all, let me picture, make you picture this, okay? Imagínate esto. Right now, and seriously, right now, Dios ya tiene who's going to be your husband and who's going to be your wife. Ya los tiene. There's somewhere. You're in Dallas. And your husband may be in Chicago. Or your wife is in Chicago. Y alguien está cenando con la que es, va a ser tu future wife. No, no la has conocido tú. But she's somewhere. And imagine, picture this, if you just knew who was the girl que Dios tenía para ti. But right now, she's talking to somebody else, and that somebody else treats that girl with no respect. ¿Les gustaría? No. So you have to treat the girl, a la muchacha, como si fuera la mujer que Dios tiene para ti. Imagínense, si arriesga uno y you're this and that, and there's a fight, and you don't care, la avientas, la jalas, oops, ya se le cayó el vestido y la tratas mal, you put her down, that means que you don't care. Pero guess what? She likes my attention. So she can stay there. So she stays there, se queda ahí, porque le gusta la atención. And she can put up with anything. ¿Por qué? Porque she knew one. Viene de una familia que no está estable. There was this girl que compartió su testimonio. There's actually this boy que compartió su testimonio. Y dijo, how can you tell me about being stable when my dad has been married 6 times? Today, de 3 marriages, uno se divorcia. That's just in Argentina. Out of the 3 couples que se casan, uno se divorcia. 65% right now, of a lot of people that they're together, out of all the marriage, 65%, they're never been married, they never made it to the court. De los que se casan a la edad de 15, a 16 years old. 65%, those are the families que they're not official married, no están casados. So, en todo el mundo está viendo una lucha, voy a ponerla aquí, y no, se le cae todo. So the 65% that of all the young people que se casan these days for pregnancy or lo que sea, they never made it to the court. They didn't get married. No se casaron. You have to understand que el propósito de la familia es de Dios y está en el corazón. That's why none of us, en todos, está un día a formar una familia. Y no, no importa cómo, de qué familia vienes, de qué, cómo estuvo tu familia, si tus papás se divorciaron, de lo que pasó, no importa, en tu corazón está un día formar una familia, un hogar, hijos con la persona que tú amas. Todos. Y el que no, es porque ha cerrado su corazón y lo ha querido hacer echar una piedra y no deja a nadie entrar, ni a Dios mismo. Porque la expresión de amor viene primero de Dios. Porque Dios es amor. No, nadie puede cambiar el sentimiento del hombre. Nadie puede cambiar el sentimiento del hombre. Todo humano quiere una familia. Todos. Y ustedes como jóvenes, jóvenes cristianos, ustedes tienen que entender algo. Que nosotros no podemos ser parte de las estadísticas. Nosotros no podemos hacer algo, pero we need to make the right choices and the right decisions. Tenemos que hacer las decisiones correctas. Y las decisiones comienzan desde ahorita, no después, desde ahorita. The way you deal with the issues and you confront your everyday life tiene que ver mucho. Cuando la manera tú eres truthful, you're real with yourself, y confrontas todos los issues, todas las cosas que hay en ti, y se lo pones a Dios. Yo quiero leerles esto. And I'm going to do it real quick. Lo que es un noviazgo de acuerdo a la Biblia. La palabra noviazgo, pues, la palabra noviazgo en la Biblia no existe. Listen to this. No existe en la Biblia la palabra noviazgo. Pero if you remember, actually, Mary and Joseph, María y José, estaban desposados, o sea, estaban para casarse. Ellos iban a casar, ellos eran novios. Y Dios usó a esta pareja, a los dos, para traer al Mesías. They were young. And he did what he did because he loved that girl. The guy, el muchacho que te va a querer, va a hacer lo que tiene que hacer porque te ama. Not because you convince him, no, porque tú, va a hacer porque te ama. He's going to do lo que tenga que hacer. ¿Por qué? Porque te ama. No por otra cosa, sino por amor. Completamente por amor. Y nosotros, una de las cosas que nosotros no entendemos es wait. We don't want to wait. No queremos esperar. Queremos saber todo. We want to know. And we don't stop and think. Many times, one of the issues sometimes with young people these days es de que convertimos encontrar o saber cuál es la novia, el novio para nuestra vida, y lo hacemos muy espiritual. Y lo hacemos muy espiritual. Y déjeme decir una cosa, para encontrar lo que Dios tiene para ti, más que espiritual, es racional. You have to be wise. You have to be smart. Not here, but let me tell you something. There were times, hubo tiempos, donde la iglesia había mucho, donde en uno de los times donde le decían, hermana, el Señor me dijo que iba a ser usted mi esposa. And people will fall for that. Mm-hmm. Back in the day, yes. Back in the day, but many times, donde había en los cultos y había, el Señor me reveló que él va a ser mi esposo, y ahí está terca la chava, porque God said it was going to be. No. Wisdom, sabiduría, wisdom. No podemos guiarnos solamente por lo espiritual o decir que, oh, es que God told me. No. Lo de Dios, God makes them, Dios hace las cosas simples y básicas. Si Dios tiene alguien para ti, no va a ser alguien que te haga daño. Listen to this. It's not going to be someone that's going to hurt you. Listen. Si tú estás pasando o experimentas alguien que te hace daño, No tiene Dios eso para ti. En el noviazgo cristiano, Jesús es la relación, el centro de la relación. Es el centro de todo lo que se lleva a cabo. En Génesis 2, capítulo 2, versículo 18, Dios dijo, porque no es bueno que los chavos, las chavas estén solas. No es bueno. No es bueno for you to picture yourself that for the future years you're going to be alone. No. It's good for you to have in your heart a thought that God has someone for you out there right now, o puede ser aquí. A mí no se me olvida. ¿Saben? Yo como si ahora mi esposa, we were having a jubileo, el Ben. And we were passing out flyers. Y como I was in fire for God, because I was passing out flyers. There was no group with me, there was nobody, and I was knocking the doors. Here in the hood, aquí. And masters. Y yo estaba tocando. Y así fue como conocí a Nora. Y la invité a la iglesia. I didn't even know that her sister ya venía a la iglesia, but she didn't want to come to church. Porque nada de jóvenes le hablaban. Eso no pasa aquí, okay? Somewhere else. But she said none of the young people will talk to her, so she didn't want to come. Y yo le dije, sister, I can talk to you. Okay. La Biblia no habla específicamente en cuanto a lo que conocemos del noviazgo. Sin embargo, para el joven cristiano, debe ser una relación seria. This is this. Seria. Una relación seria. You gotta be serious about it. He's like, okay, how old you gotta be para pensar en esto? How old? When you're preparing yourself. Te estás preparando para tener una relación seria con alguien. El noviazgo es una responsabilidad. Because the sad thing, if we don't be responsible, if we want something, okay, Dios tenga alguien con nosotros, all we're gonna be doing is messing people's life. Dañando la vida de otros. ¿Por qué? Porque no estamos serios. Y Dios quiere que nosotros seamos serios en las cosas que hacemos. El noviazgo es una relación con mirada hacia el matrimonio. No tiene que terminar en boda ni en matrimonio, pero el noviazgo siempre termina. El noviazgo termina en dos cosas: breakup o matrimonio. Y cuando no es de Dios, termina en completamente un breakup, which is a mess. ¿Por qué? Porque we not being wise. We're not stopping ourselves and say, I need to be wise and know and listen to God, to speak in our heart and obey. Dios nos habla. ¿A cuánto Dios les habla de when we're making a wrong decision? ¿Cuánto Dios les habla? Raise your hands y Dios te habla. Dios te habla cuando estamos haciendo una decisión que we know we're not following God's decision. So, si Dios te habla, es para que escuches y para que obedezcas. El noviazgo es una relación que se necesita el compromiso con Dios y ser serio y tener madurez. Tener madurez. No esperes cambiar a la persona o hacerla a tu manera, porque Dios tiene la persona para ti, para que dos mundos se conozcan. Cuando Dios está en medio de dos jóvenes que se aman, Dios los va a ayudar a crecer. Dios los va a ayudar a entender el propósito para su vida. Es bien importante que nosotros sepamos que no podemos darle la espalda porque nos pasó algo en el pasado y darle la espalda y decir, ya no hay nadie para mí. Nosotros tenemos que abrir el corazón de lo que Dios traiga para nosotros y orar. Y orar. Decirle al Señor, Señor, yo quiero que traiga la persona correcta para mi vida. Two of the most important things, even more important than your de tu school, de muchas cosas. Your salvation. Second, ¿con quién te vas a casar? Porque puedes ser el mejor exitoso doctor, el mejor exitoso hombre de negocio, pero tener el peor matrimonio. El peor. So, si puedes tener el mejor talento, el mejor, pero no el matrimonio, hicimos una decisión mala. A mí me duele. I work with young people for 19 years and see all the young people. When after being in church for so long, sometimes we don't stop and listen what God is telling us. Dios es un Dios de oportunidades. Dios es un Dios de nuevos días, de new times for our lives. Dios es un Dios que abre un espacio even after our past, los errores, los mistakes que hicimos, pero Dios siempre abre una puerta para poder comenzar y hacer las cosas bien. ¿Por qué les hablo de esto, de noviazgo? Porque a veces we always avoid that issue and we always thinking, well, the jóvenes, they're young, they don't need to listen to this. Yes, you do. You need to know that when you go have a relationship, you need to be mature and have Jesus involved in that relationship. If you're not, you're just playing with yourself. These young people, these young couples, que van a hacer seminarios a high schools y a escuelas, ellos no mencionan a nada a Dios, pero sí hablan la pureza. Y hablan la pureza de una manera que es muy entendible porque La pureza te beneficia a ti mismo. When you keep yourself to yourself, it gives you a better chance for a better lifestyle, family lifestyle. Yo les iba a enseñar ese video, pero no tuvimos aquí. Pero this guy, that's all he's doing. He's sharing. Él está compartiendo el compromiso de la pureza. And he met this girl. Que this girl came from a broken home. And her life was so empty. Y cada vez que ella hacía algo incorrecto, the next day, the next morning, she will, well, ella estaba with all the regrets in her heart and her mind about all the things that she did that they were not right. But the next weekend, que todos los amigos iban a party and they would have fun and drink and hacían todo eso, she will fall the same mistake. And the next day, again, all the regrets and all the thoughts that what she did wrong, and she will not feel clean about herself. Se sentía ella mal y se sentía ella muy, de su vida destrozada. And this young man came and preached to her sobre un pacto de pureza. To wait. Y dice, why wait? ¿Por qué esperar? Because you owe it to yourself. You owe it to the person that you're going to get married one day. Te vas a casar. Porque es the best choice for you. En lo que todo el mundo cree otra cosa totalmente diferente, this young couple están yendo a escuelas y a high schools y a todos estos lugares hablando sobre pureza sin mencionar a Dios. Ahora nosotros que creemos que Dios es santo, God is holy, Dios es santo, y la Biblia dice que si Él es santo, nosotros también tenemos que ser santos. Imagínense esta pareja que está llevando este mensaje a todas las escuelas, and there's so many young people, they come out of their shop crying, saying, I never realized that. That my sexual life is for the one who's going to be my husband, my wife. You know how good it's for me to know that my wife nunca conoció ningún hombre antes. I'm always at peace, I always have peace heart. I'm not going to say que no discutimos y todo, pero we never have issues donde nos dejamos de hablar o nada de eso. We work together. Somos esposos. La conocí en 1999. 1999, I met my wife. Passing out flyers. And then she came to an event. But there was a hermana from church. She was like, Ismael, I want you to know this girl. Oh, she needs so much about Jesus. Please, can you pick her up so she can go to the youth event and be with you? And at that time, I was in charge of the drama thing. And I had the spotlight. And I went to pick up the girl. And that girl came with me. Oh, Lord, that girl came dressed all muchimama.com. Like the dress. I was like, oh, my God, you going to church with me like that? Yes. What's wrong? I thought I mentioned to you that I was inviting you to a church. And what's wrong with your church? Man, pobre hermano, they were like, was dressed like here. Muy bonita la muchacha, muy. And then el evento se terminó. We were doing the drama, el de resurrection drama, con Carmen. And I was in charge of, I was the director of the drama and todo eso. Then I was. And de repente, una girl de allá, the first floor, y se asoma. It was Nora, my wife. But when she saw me with the girl, she never talked to me for a while after. But you know what? That's good. That was a good sign, you know? That was a good sign. And for me, it was one. So that night, le hablo yo a mi little niece, hey, vente, te vas a ir conmigo. I was driving a little truck, y me traje a mi sobrina conmigo. And the girl's like, it's not like I'm going to bite you. Why you have to bring your little niece? Like, well, it's just the homeless, we're going out after this, and I want you to see if you can come with us. No, I want to go home. All right, I'll take you home. I was so ready to get, I didn't want to say mean, but I was so ready to get rid of me. I was so ready to get rid of her. Porque ella no era un tipo de joven para mí. Porque when you want to serve God, you have to be realistic. What kind of girls for you? You see, you have to be wise. You have to be wise. So then after that, we met Nora again, and Pasó un año. And one thing that I like about Nora, but it bothered me a lot. It did a lot, seriously. When we go out to eat, she would be following me on her car. After a month, todavía. After 6 months, she still be following my car. Like, why don't you come with me in my car? Oh no, I cannot do that. I know I asked God for someone, but not that old fashioned. I'm like, man. I was like, wow. She played really hard to get. That's what, you know, which girls, that's what you gotta do. Seriously, I mean, and then a girl from Monterrey llegó a church. I mean, you know, when a new girl, a new guy comes to church, and y'all know what I'm talking about, so I don't have to give you no details on that. So a new girl came to church. Y ella andaba con todos los jóvenes from Monterrey, muy simpática y todo. And Nora decided to move to McAllen. And I was done with long distance relationship. So I'm like, you know what? This is over. It's not going to work. I've been praying for. Yo estaba orando por una novia, pero I don't want to be no having no novia phone calls and all that. And guess what she said? She said, "It's fine." I'm like, what? Really? Man. Well, guess what? And then all the homies we were going skating. Pasaron como like a month. And the girl de Monterrey comenzó, like, you know, getting close to me. Y la mamá decía, Ismael, el Señor me dice que tú vas a ser el esposo de mi hija. I'm like, oh, my God. No. You know, one of those things where parents like, oh, tú vas a ser. Hey, we have to be realistic. Sometimes we get so religious that we make calls for things that we're not supposed to. Y esa hermana venía y decía, el Señor me, I've been praying, el Señor me dice que. And that girl was up to no good. Pero anyways, she was cute. So comenzamos a que ir, que íbamos para acá con los jóvenes todos juntos. And guess what? Nora, my wife, came back. And Nora was not the type of girl that she would look for me. Yo la buscaba ella. But that Saturday night, she called me. Y me dijo, hola, ¿cómo estás? Oh, regresaste. Dice, yeah. Pues si quieres venir, los jóvenes vamos a ir a ice skating. Okay. So all the hoodies gathered in my house, a lot of cars, there was a lot of trucks. And the girl from Monterrey, she was fixing to step in my truck. Y Nora le hizo un lado, and she went and sit down in my truck. I'm like, she's in serious business. She ain't no games. Y cuando yo miré, dije, wait a minute. Okay, porque así es. To make the story short, yo estaba en serio, I was serious with my wife, with my ex, you know, mi novia. And then I was going through problems. Listen, todas las relaciones van a ir por problemas. All relations are going to go through struggles. And how do y'all know that y'all make to each other? When you help each other, not put down each other. Not throw to the ground or put guilt, or, no. And I came to the pastora. Pastora, I'm going through this big issue. All the jóvenes, again, the jóvenes, we're going. He said, I have this event, and all the jóvenes, we're supposed to go on Six Flags. We're going, hopefully we're going to Six Flags this year. We're going to Six Flags. And right there, su hermano, and I'm talking about at that time, Nora, she was 21. Su hermano le dijo, you're not going. And guess what? When we went and picked her up, her truck estaba sentada en bloques. The brother took all the wheels and the tires and left the car. Okay? But guess what? I was not going, and I was like, I'm not going to get chicken. I'm not going to turn into a chicken. So I went and looked for the brother, and he didn't want to talk to me. So I came and talked to the pastora. Le dije, pastora, I'm really serious about Nora. And guess what? This happened. Y la pastora, you know, chaparrita, really like that. Y me dice, así, traía su Biblia. It was just service. It was done. You love her? Is she like, yes or no?
He was saying, no, sí.
Okay. He said, what are you waiting? They go, what are you waiting? Okay, talk to the parents. Es que no están aquí. ¿Dónde están? All the way to Las Cruces, New Mexico. 14 hours from here. He go, ¿y? ¿La quieres? Yeah. ¿Amas a Nora? Sí. Pues vete a Las Cruces. Muy bien. So I grabbed 3 jóvenes and we did a road trip all the way to Las Cruces, New Mexico. And went over there. And we went to this raggedy cheap hotel to spend the night because I was paying all the expenses. Homeboys weren't broke, so I was paying all the expenses. Yeah, people said, and all the guys, they go ahead and jump and just eat in the hotel. The beds were made out of wood. But we were having so much fun. Next morning, le hablo a papá y Nora. Buenos días, ¿cómo está? Habla Ismael. Buenos días, ¿quién es? Soy Ismael, el novio de Nora. They knew at that time. We were 21. She was 21 and I was 22. Pues bueno, dime, ¿qué pasó? ¿Qué quieres? Es que quiero hablar con usted. Me dice, no, yo estoy acá en Las Cruces, Nuevo México. Si quieres, espérame, ¿qué eres? Dice, no, es que quiero hablar con usted en persona. No, pues no podemos. Dije, es que yo estoy aquí. ¿Cómo? Aquí estoy. Estoy en Las Cruces, Nuevo México. Highway 10, en el hotel de la esquina. Ah, pues vente. ¿Para dónde? Salte del hotel y tú dale cuando el sol se mete. I didn't know that. So, when estaba, oh man, y fue así, cuando se mete el sol, estos jóvenes, these young people don't know nothing. So, voy, ya hablo con él y digo, yo quiero a su hija. I love you, daughter. And I'm serious about you, daughter. That's what he said. No tenías que haber hecho eso. Yes, guys. When you love somebody, you have to do what you gotta do, but do it the right way. The right way. True love waits. El verdadero amor espera. Y el verdadero amor tiene que hacer lo que tiene que hacer when you love somebody. I had a lot of issues of low self-esteem. I'll be honest with you. I love God and everything, pero yo venía de una familia pobre. Seriously, pobre. I can tell you so many stories that really como vivía mi familia. And many of y'all have not gone through that. So I always had a low self-esteem issue that I didn't want a girl que me iba a pedir nada. That she will be happy or whatever I could offer. I didn't want a girl to be pushing me down or comparing me with somebody else because I don't give her that. How come this? How come this couple has this? How come this? I didn't want that. So I had this self-esteem. But I told God that I want to do the right thing. So you have to ask God that you want to do the right thing. Because if you want to do the right thing, first, you love God. Second, you love yourself. Third, you love what God is bringing to your life. And you do the right thing. Y cuando regresé, the brother puso los rines de las llantas, arregló todo. And now, after almost 2 years of relationship, for the first time, when I came back, Nora got in my truck and we ride together.
You believe that?
Yes. Really? Like 1940, 1960. But she was like that. Pero ¿saben qué? Yo le pedí a Dios a alguien así. Alguien que se amara a sí mismo. Alguien que quisiera y que tuviera en su corazón a Dios y que quisiera formar una familia. Y algo tan hermoso es que Nora siempre se respetó y me enseñó a respetarla. Girls, you're the key to teach the guys to respect you. You are. Y es algo importante. Es algo importante que Dios quiere lo mejor para ti. No lo que el mundo enseña, sino el plan de Dios. Y el plan de Dios es mejor, porque Dios no se equivoca. Dios no se equivoca ni comete errores. There were so many friends. Habían muchos amigos. And it is so sad, kids. And I'm going to tell you this, and I'm not judging nobody. I'm not saying no names. But let me tell you something. It's easy. It's not easy. It's not easy to wait until you get married. It's not, because the whole world is doing something different. And there's bad things in your flesh. We're in the flesh. Don't act all spiritual with me. No, we're in the flesh. Y malos pensamientos pasan por sus mentes. Malas cosas pasan por sus mentes. Pero tú tienes que entender es que Dios está contigo. Y Dios no te juzga. Él te quiere levantar. Every day He wants to pick you up and grab your hand and lead your life to the right path so you can do the right thing for your future. But you don't make the decision for your future tomorrow. You make it today. Hoy es el propósito de Dios. Hay muchos puntos. Tú siempre buscas the blessing of your parents. Yes. The blessing of your parents is important with the person that you choose.
Yes.
La bendición de tus papás. Hey, mom, te quiero presentar a alguien. O te dicen, no, a mí no me traigas ningún novio hasta que sea el verdadero. Y entonces, pa, ay, tu idea andas tras uno, tras otro, you just messing up your life. Wait. You thought about just true love waits just because we're saying about the relationship with another guy? No. True love to yourself. You do the right thing and you wait. Because if you don't love yourself, you cannot love someone else. So todo comienza contigo. Todo comienza conmigo.
Todo comienza conmigo.
No pienses que alguien es va, someone is going to fulfill the gaps of the emptiness of your life because everything starts with ourselves, with you. Dios es el único que puede llenar tu vida. God is the only one que fulfill your life, que puede llenar tu vida completamente, es Dios. Dios no tiene problema que tú, you have fun, que tengas, te diviertas, hagas cosas, que pases buenos momentos. Dios quiere todo eso para ti, pero que hagas las cosas bien. Que hagas las cosas bien. La bendición de tus padres es muy importante para ti. La bendición de líderes, pastores, amigos tuyos es importante. Muchas parejas no se creen en casarse. A lot of young people, they don't believe in marriage no more. Todos los artistas lo hacen, no se casan. So why are you married? No. Eso no es de Dios. Eso no es de Dios. Todo comienza en ti. Todo comienza hoy. Perdonarte a ti mismo el pasado. Perdonar todo lo que hayas cometido. Comenzar hoy. Pedirle perdón a Dios si un día tú dijiste, there's no good girls, there's no good guys, there's not. Pedirle perdón a Dios porque cuando tú dices eso, you doubt in what God can bring to your life. Estás dudando lo que Dios pueda traer a tu vida. Because God has someone for you. Dios tiene alguien para ti. And someone special. Pero don't expect that someone that is going to fulfill your life or all the gaps of your life because that one is God. So then, you are complete in God, y Dios trae a ti las cosas. Una persona que está herida, someone that is hurt by the past, una persona que está herida, is not going to be able to see what's in front of him or in front of her. No va a poder mirar porque el daño te hace judge people by the way you see people. Y no es así. Tú tienes que tener un corazón sano. They say the girls, you know, sometimes they're so critical, picky, que cuando viene el príncipe azul, it's not the right blue that they want. That blue, that el príncipe azul, that was just a little bit dark blue, that was a little bit light. That's what they say. Que así son las muchachas. Es bien importante entender, listen. And I had issue with that, so believe me, yo entiendo eso. Es bien importante saber tu aspecto y tu concepto, what you see yourself in the future doing, es bien importante. You don't wait to see yourself having a good future until you're 20-something. You see yourself now. If you cannot picture yourself doing great, even if you're not doing, and even if you're doing the worst at this moment, pero si tú no te puedes visualizar haciendo bien, va a ser muy difícil. Cuando Nora y yo nos casamos, yo tenía un Monte Carlo. I had a van, a workman, que somebody le instaló un asiento. El asiento iba so far que cuando Nora la usaba tenía que poner like 5 pillows so she can reach to the pedals. Pero nunca me dijo nada. Hey, ¿por qué me traen a la gente estar en la fea? No, yo quiero andar en la calle. She never said that. You see, she never did. And I was happy as a man. Que nunca viniera y throw myself in my face. She's like, why do we have this ugly van? It's the nastiest van of the church. She never said that. But guess what? I visualized Nora not saying that. You understand what I'm talking about? Yo visualicé que Nora will not do that because the way she was. You follow me? So ustedes tienen, you have to see the person that you like y la persona que Dios tiene para usted, but you have to be reasonable. Tienes que ser razonable. Wisdom. Or you can be on your knees praying and just be all spiritual and you're still not going nothing because God demands for you to have wisdom to make right decisions. And God gives us wisdom. No, Dios nos da sabiduría. Y el carro, oh Lord, I was in school at the Catholic Church in San Agustin. Yes, I was there. Yeah, it's okay. I was there. And I was going there for a year in school. And I had to wait till everybody to leave porque the doors no se abrían, so I would jump through the window. I would come home. So cuando me casé, guess what? Pobre Norita, siempre me dijo. Pero nunca me dijo. And that was nice. Right, man? I grew up here. Can put up with you as you grow. Probably you would have thought about those things. So I thank God for my wife. This year, este año, vamos a estar casados por 21 años. 21 years. Yeah. Let's all stand up. Mi problema de closer Agustín, algo yo sabía, yo le oré a Dios porque venía de una familia que literally no tenía nada.